Hello, and welcome back to Route 85 and part 4 on our little series on opening a link in Chrome on iOS. Now, if you've been following along up until this point, we've basically finished our main goal of opening up a link in Chrome, adding a back button that reopens our app, and using our open source library to help you do it all quickly and easily. So you can think of today's episode as a little bit of extra credit. See, as long as we're exploring the idea of URL schemes and callback URLs, let's take a closer look at this x-success callback URL that we're defining. Right now, it's just sent to my app's custom scheme, and that's it. But we could actually embed any information we want in this URL. Let's say, for instance, we wanted to tell the user how happy we are that they clicked on that back button when they came back to our app. Well, we could modify our callback URL to be something like com:google:my:example:\\welcome-back. If we URL encode this thing and make it part of our x-callback URL, this will get passed along to Chrome as the URL to open when the user clicks the back button to go back to our app. So when Chrome attempts to open this URL, iOS will open up our application, because we've claimed ownership to the com:google:my:example custom URL scheme, and then we'll pass this full URL along to our application's app delegate. But then how do we read in this URL that gets sent back to our app? By implementing the application open URL source application annotation method in our app delegate. This takes in the full URL that opened up our app in the first place, along with a few other bits of information. So maybe this is better demonstrated in code, so let's give it a try in our sample app. So here we are back in my fancy opening Chrome example application. And I'm going to do two things here. The first thing I'm going to do is change my callback URL from just this com:google:open-in-chrome:example:: to com:google:open-in-example:\\welcome-back-from-button\. And then the next thing I'm going to do is jump into my app-delegate.m file. And let's say up here at the top, I'm going to add this application open URL source application annotation method that I alluded to earlier. So this is application, here it is, open URL source application annotation. And I guess maybe the first thing I will do here is let's just log the URL that we get back. So nslog, I have received the URL, and then we'll pass in URL absolute string. But, you know, spoiler alert, it's just going to be the callback URL that we specified in our viewcontroller.m file. And we can return yes for now, just to say, yes, I can handle this URL, even though I actually don't know what it is yet. And so now when we run this, so click on the button, go into Chrome, jump back. Let's stop this, and we can see that in the logs, yes, the URL we've received is in fact this com:google:open-in-chrome:example:\\welcome-back-from-button. Man, I need shorter URLs. But now we can analyze that. So I'm going to add a little if URL host is equal to string, and this is welcome-back-from-button. So if this is the case, then we know that the user has gotten into our application from clicking on that back button in Chrome and not from, say, another X callback URL we were to create in the future. And so then why don't we add a little alert box or something to welcome the user back? Something like this. UI alert view, Alec, init with title, welcome back, message, we missed you. Our delegate here can be nil, cancel button can be aw, and other button titles, there aren't any, and show. There we go. Oops. Yes, I need the little at sign. There we go. And then I am returning yes here at the end of this method to signal that, yes, we have properly handled the URL. I'm not actually sure what effect this has in the app, since I can return no here and I still get to open the URL. My suspicion is that you want to return the correct value here in case you have a subclass app delegate, and your subclass delegate, you need to know whether or not you have a URL that hasn't been handled yet by your super, but that's just a guess. I don't really know for sure. Anyway, let's run this. So I tap my button, goes into Chrome, tap the back button. Aw, look at that. This is a welcome back dialogue. Aw, I feel so loved. For a more realistic example, we could imagine that we had an app that contained a bunch of news story headlines, and a user could click on one of those headlines to read the full story in Chrome. So we could pass along within our URL arguments the internal ID of whatever story or news post contained this external link in the first place. Then when the user returns to our app, we can use this information to, for example, make sure the user continues browsing from where they left off, or we could prompt them with some follow-up options, or we could mark the story as read. You kind of get the idea. Anyway, hopefully this tutorial gives you a better understanding of what URL schemes are, how to use them to open up a web page in the user's favorite browser, whatever that might be, and how to take advantage of that nice little back button in Chrome to send the user back to your app. So thanks so much for watching. Hey, this was my first set of screencasts in a while. What'd you think? Was this too fast, too slow? Is there something else you want me to cover? Are you like, let's do all Swift all the time? You know, let me know down here in the comments, and I will be sure to read them. Thanks again, and I'll talk to you soon.